So in the solution to this problem set, we've added a for loop whose index ranges from 0 to the number of steps. We put the number of steps plus 1 as the argument for range because I will go up to the number inside minus 1. Inside the loop, we've created a variable called angle, which is equal to 2 pi times the index divided by the number of steps that are taken in the trajectory. Now if we look over at this picture, you can sort of see what's happening. The moon starts in this position, then after one time step it's moved to this position, and so on and so forth. The number of segments will equal the number of steps, and the number of lines will equal the number of steps plus 1. After this, we use the array x to define the horizontal and vertical positions of the moon at any given time step. It's at this point that we have to remember our trigonometric functions sine and cosine. In this first line right here, we're defining the horizontal position of x for the ith time step. And the second line, which uses sine, is what's going to show us the vertical position. This is one of those cases where being able to see a right triangle in this picture is very helpful. Looking at our picture, this horizontal line right here that extends from the Earth out to the moon's orbit is the 0 radian or 0 degree line. We're measuring all of the angles that the moon is going to be marked at up from this line. That means that at any given moment, we can draw a line from the moon down to this horizontal line to create a right triangle, which will then allow us to use sine and cosine in conjunction with this angle to determine the moon's vertical and horizontal distance from the Earth. Coming back to our code, after all of this is filled in, if we run the program, we end up with a perfect circle, just like we were hoping to get for the trajectory of the moon around the Earth in this ideal simulation.